Hello children, how are you? Are you all happy? Praise to be God Jesus. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's start our class with a short prayer. Heavenly Father, bless us for this day. We thank you for being able to see, hear, touch, feel and walk this morning. Provide a way for those who lack any of these, we pray. Amen. Children, let's study 6th chapter, Ministers of the Church. Children, tell me, Jesus had how many disciples? Yes, Jesus had 12 disciples. Children, they were called apostles. Children, they were called apostles. Yes, the disciples were called apostles. Apostles means one who is sent. Children, apostles means one who is sent. Children, do you know who bishop is? Bishops are the successors of the apostles. Once again, bishops are the successors of the apostles. Children, now tell me, do you know who is the most important disciple of Jesus? Yes, Simon was the most important disciple of Jesus. Once again, who is the most important disciple of Jesus? Simon is the most important disciple of Jesus. Simon is the most important disciple of Jesus. Jesus called him Simon Peter. Jesus called Simon Peter. Peter means rock. Children, Peter means rock. Jesus called Simon Peter. Yes, children, who is the present Pope? Children, tell me, who is the present Pope? Pope Francis is the present Pope. He is the 266th of Pope. Children, Jesus made Peter as the foundation stone for his church. Once again, Jesus made Peter as the foundation stone for his church. All churches built on Peter, the rock. Once again, our churches built on Peter, the rock. Children, Peter was chosen as the first minister of the church. Children, who was chosen as the first minister of the church? Yes. Peter was chosen as the first minister of the church. Who are the successors of Peter? Popes are the successors of the Peter. Once again, popes are successors of Peter. Okay, children, listen a story. After Pentecost, the church began to grow. The apostles were not able to do all the tasks. So they chose 7 men full of spirit and wisdom. One of them was Stephen. Stephen attacked the deceptive gods of the Jews. Stephen praised Jesus to the skies. When the Jews heard these things, they became angry and shouted, "Stone him! Stone him!" They stoned Stephen. That brave son, bathed in blood, knelt down and prayed, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. Devout men buried Stephen and made loud lamentation over him. Children, what are the 5 precepts of the church?
The 5 precepts of the church. First one, you shall attend Holy Mass on Sundays and holy days of obligation. Second one, you shall confess your sins at least once a year and receive Holy Communion at least during the Easter season. Third one, you shall keep fasting and abstinence on the days fixed by the church. Fourth one, you shall not celebrate marriage during the forbidden periods and with the forbidden people. Fifth one, you shall contribute to the support of the church and pastors according to the norms of the church. Once again, you shall attend Holy Mass on Sundays and holy days of obligation. You shall confess your sins at least once a year and receive Holy Communion at least during the Easter season. You shall keep fasting and abstinence on the days fixed by the Church. You shall not celebrate marriage during the forbidden periods and with the forbidden people. You shall contribute to the support of the Church and pastors according to the norms of the Church.
Okay children, let's wind up our class with a short prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay children, see you in the next class. Bye. God bless you.